I'm going to show you the step-by-step process to setting up the Digibyte one-click miner and show you how easy it really is. So let's go ahead and start mining some Digibyte. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to set up a mining pool account. There's two options to do this. You can use the digihash.co mining pool, which is very simple and easy. All you need to do is literally go and download a Digibyte wallet, and then you can use your wallet address as your username. I'm going to go over here to theblocksfactory.com. I'm going to click on the Digibyte Skyne pool account, and I'm going to sign up for an account. All I need to do is register for the pool. I can make my username, click my password. So now that we have our account set up, you're going to click on my account and set up a worker. The worker is basically your mining machine or your computer. So I'm going to add a new worker, and it's going to be patrickwieland.worker2, and then my password is going to be work. Now that I have that set up, I'm going to go ahead and save that, and that'll be my worker. And we're going to need that information here in a second. You'll see what we're going to need this for. But now that we have a pool account set up, it's time to download the Digibyte one-click miner. So there will be a link below in the description where you can download the miner for free from GitHub, and you can also get it from our website as well. So you have those options, and once you download it, it'll be just a .exe file, and you download it. Sometimes computers think that there is a Trojan or a virus because of the mining software, so it might come up as a red flag. You're going to need to uncheck that, let it download to your system. Don't worry, there's no virus, there's no Trojan. Some computers, some antivirus will flag it as an issue, so don't worry. Go ahead and download the .exe file, the Digibyte miner. We'll have the version 1 once this video goes live. You can download that. That'll be the first real version of the Digibyte one-click miner. Go in your downloads file and drop it onto your desktop. I like to do that because it's easier to get to later on. You can just drop it right over to your desktop. Also, sometimes when you do open it for the first time, it'll ask you if you want to search for the app in the App Store. Just press yes, it'll open. And then once it opens, you'll see this is the one-click miner. I've already had this open before, so it's going to automatically start mining. But you can see going into this and setting it up. So depending on what pool you chose, you can go over to the little right, and then you're going to click on your pool. So for this video, I'm using the Blocks Factory mining pool. Once I click it in the pool, it'll actually set up my pool address automatically, so I don't have to actually copy and paste that. So this is the one important part. You're going to need to update your account.worker name, and that's going to be your account from your mining pool and then your worker name for your mining machine or whichever one you named it. So for me, it's patrickwieland.worker2. Remember, we set that up in our mining pool earlier. So if you named your worker Rocketship, it needs to be whatever your username is, .rocketship. And I'm going to put my password for that worker in the password box there. So now I have my pool set up. I'm going to go ahead and click finish here, and I'm going to be ready to mine. Also, in the top right is your settings box. You can click to have it so that once you turn your computer on, the one-click miner will launch on startup and also will automatically start mining once you open the program. Ready to start mining. So all I need to do is press start, and the program will automatically download the miner and get everything going, and we should be good to go here. So now the miner is starting up, and in a second you'll actually see the little screen that'll show all the information about the miner. You can see there it's showing all my information, showing my username, showing my worker name, and it's all set up good to go. So everything looks normal, and we are mining. It's happening. We are actually mining. So it's that quick and that easy to start mining Digibyte. Another thing you can do to increase your mining power is you can overclock your GPUs, your graphics cards. So you can download, depending on if you have NVIDIA or an AMD, you can download an overclock program. I'm going to be using MSI Afterburner for this video. So for the Skyne algorithm, I use 205 core clock. I put my memory clock as low as possible, and then I'm also going to move my power limit down a little bit, and that'll kind of give me my optimal hash power for mining with the Skyne algorithm. All we need is core clock for the Skyne algorithm. So now that I optimized my graphics card, we'll go back over here and you'll actually see that my hash power is increasing. And also, when you do start it up for the first time, it'll take a little bit of time, you know, 5 minutes or so before the GPU really gets to the point where it's like optimal. And that'll kind of be what you're really going to be mining at in terms of your hash power. And you can see how it's kind of increasing a little bit by a little bit as this has been going and running. So once you see all these yeses, that means you're good to go. It means you are mining. Right top box, you're going to see profitability. After you mine for a day or so, it's going to start to give you a little bit better idea of how much Digibyte you'll be earning depending on your hash power. But to make sure that everything is working right, I'm going to go back into the mining pool, look at my worker. My worker should show that there is valid hash rate. Now I can see there's valid hash rate. It'll take a little bit of time for it to refresh and give me the actual number, but you can see that the pool is receiving information from the miner. So we are good to go in that sense. We are mining. We are getting Digibyte after really just downloading, setting up a mining pool, and then once you've done this once or twice, it's even easier to do it in the future. Don't worry. It seems a little bit difficult right now, but it is very simple and easy once you get the hang of it and once you get an idea of what everything is and where it should go and all that. So we're trying to make it as easy as possible for you guys to be able to set up your miner and get it all going. There's also an intensity slider. I wouldn't worry about this if you don't really know much about it. You can do some research in the future, kind of figure out what your intensity sweet spot is depending on what cards you have, what your system likes. Every system is going to be a little bit different. There's no perfect number when it comes to intensity and stuff like that. So you really just want to kind of mess with it and figure out your sweet spot and kind of optimize it for your system. And over time, you'll kind of figure out, you know, what the best settings are for you. So really just start messing with it, start using it, and learn more about Digibyte. If you want to learn more about Digibyte in general, check out digibyte.co. You can learn more about the blockchain and everything like that.